On the floor for the visiting Milwaukee Bucks, at shooting guard, Grayson Allen. It's time to introduce the starting five for your Sacramento Kings. At power forward, standing 6'8", number 13, Keegan Murray. At forward, 6'8", number 40, Harrison Ball. At the shooting guard position, 6'7", number 9, Kevin Herter. At guard, 6'3", number 5, De'Aaron Fox. Starting at center, 7'1", number 10, Domantas Sabonis.
Hello, basketball fans. You've got it on 2K Sports as we get set to bring you exciting NBA action. Hello, everyone. I'm Brian Anderson, joined by Grant Hill and Clark Kellogg. We'll hear from reporter Allie LaForce in a moment. Allie, it's all yours.
The Bucks' Chris Middleton has a fan and head coach, Mike Budenholzer. Bud said, quote, he's the ultimate professional, so consistent, and he does it in a lot of different ways. At the same time, he is a great leader. The scoring and the threes, everybody sees, but I like how he's taken on leadership. Brian?
Well, he's a key player for them, Allie. And while we have a second, let's take a quick peek at the rebounding numbers for Bobby Portis.
On the board, he's had a much bigger impact these last few years than he did before that. He can be relied on now to make a difference with his rebounding, and that's a product of how hard he's worked down low.
Let's check out Milwaukee's starting lineup. On the perimeter, it's Allen and Middleton. Giannis and Lopez are the bigs. And it's Holiday in at the point guard position. And for Sacramento, Fox runs point with Herter by his side. Up front, it'll be Murray and Sabonis. And it's Barnes in at the three. And tonight, we're looking at two teams who make their living beyond the arc, Grant.
Yeah, they love to shoot the three-point shot, and they do it effectively. And of course, that means these two teams understand the importance of good spacing. They're great shooters on both sides, to be sure, but motion and ball movement are the real keys to their three-point attacks.
Now here's Herter. Kupo with the block. Now Allen. Pass to Lopez. Misses the three. Here's Herter. Down low. Out to Fox. Sabonis with a screen on Holiday. Sabonis finds Herter. Down to five on the shot clock. Late clock here. The Kings need to get one up. Barnes, no good. Allen against Herter. Holiday, a screen on Murray. Antetokounmpo, that's good.
Boy, in his relatively short career, Giannis has figured out just about every way to get the ball in the basket, even with the guy draped all over him.
And seems hard to believe, but it's been almost 40 years since the Kings moved to Sacramento.
And you know, maybe they haven't hung any banners, but they've had some special players and some great seasons in that time. And they mean a lot to that community.
Murray can score in a multitude of ways, Grant.
Oh, yes, he can, B.A. I mean, he can feast from the post, the mid-range, and the three-point line as well. He always plays under control at his own pace, and that's why he looks so fluid out there on the floor.
The free throw drops from Murray.
And the physical style Murray plays with will serve him well in this league.
And that one goes in. Two from the line that time.
two-part equation. You have to be aggressive enough to get to the line, then talented enough to sink them.
Holiday against Fox. Allen, the pass to Middleton. Drills it from deep.
Well, there's a good reason this guy shoots as many threes as he does. Chris Middleton is a knockdown three-point shooter.
Pass to Sabonis. It's Herter on the wing. And the layup is good off the glass.
Just taking it right to the rim, and no one was there to greet him.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
Antetokounmpo. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take two free throws.
And last season, Giannis passing Kareem Abdul-Jabbar as the Bucks' all-time leading scorer. He wants to finish his career in Milwaukee, so that total bound to grow.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first one falls. And Grant, both Giannis and Kareem dominated the paint, but they get it done differently.
Yeah, that they do. Kareem, possibly the best ever in the post, whereas Giannis might be the most dominant slasher and driver in league history.
And so Antetokounmpo nails both of them. You know, Clark, only a handful of teams have won more individual MVP awards than the Bucks.
That's really interesting, B.A., that you mentioned that. But that's how it goes when you have players like Kareem and Giannis walking through your door. And who knows, Giannis might have even more in him before he's done.
And Sabonis the bucket on the assist by Fox.
Hard not to respect how good Fox is in the pick and roll. Excellent at making the pocket pass.
Antetokounmpo, that's good.
Starting to find his rhythm. He's cooking, and he knows it.
And you know what? They're going to keep using him. I mean, he'll be the centerpiece of their offense today. You can bank on that.
Fox, the pass to Sabonis. Outside Herter. And the basket is good. Herter's got his second basket.
This team looks to him to score the ball. They feel good when he's taking the shots.
Holiday. And Holiday powers it home.
You know, he attracts a lot of attention, and Lopez making the most of it there to set his teammate up with an open look.
Outside Barnes from deep three-point range. Rebounded by the Bucks. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Warriors.
There was just no sense of urgency to hit the offensive glass. They have to be disappointed in the lack of second chance points.
Yeah, I agree. Hard to win games when every offensive possession is one shot, then a jog back the other way to play defense.
Now here's Sabonis. Out to the wing. Outside Barnes. Sabonis with a screen on Middleton. The three from Barnes. Giannis with the rebound.
Yeah, and the defense has really got to tighten up on him. I mean, he's just too dangerous from the three-point line.
Holiday passes to Middleton. Fades away. No good that time. So Sacramento will take it the other way. Their last game, a win against the Suns. Looking to carry it into this one.
Yeah, they connected from outside all game. And the defense had absolutely no answer for them.
They found their rhythm and kept piling it on. And a huge boost of confidence on the road for sure.
And you love to see the aggressiveness, using the height advantage to hammer it home.
And the Bucks call time here. 31 left in the first. Carter, the pass to Ingles. Portis against Holmes. Pass to Crowder. Ingles from outside. And it's Sacramento with the rebound. Outside Monk. Outside Mitchell. Monk with it. Now Carter defending. The three from Mitchell knocks it down from distance.
Love the unselfishness of Monk there. I mean, love seeing him find the open man.
Now here's Crowder. Right now averaging 5.5 a game. Outside, Ingles. Crowder outside. Pass to Carter. Launches it. And the Bucks miss again. The Kings trailing. 8-second difference between the shot clock and game clock. Now Mitchell. Holmes with it. Covered by Connaughton. Shoots a fadeaway. Holmes, no good.
Unnecessary to go to the fadeaway there. It wasn't needed. Could have just kept it simple and taken the easy shot.
Pass to Portis. Goes up and lays it in nice and easy.
Attacking in the painted area. Clearly that was their game plan coming in.
And that concludes a back and forth, high scoring first quarter of play. Bucks ahead, up three. Stay with us now as we get set to bring you quarter number two after this. Matchup after this first quarter of play. All right, guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for Milwaukee.
They've done a great job facilitating shooters. Their early game has seen a lot of hot passes and has kept the defense guessing as well.
And, you know, in no time at all, they've also started finding points inside, already taking apart that interior defense.
Grant, we always talk about great footwork for post players, but how about perimeter players?
You know, I'm glad you brought that up, B.A. Great perimeter players have elite footwork. The footwork helps to create the opportunity to score, whether that's shooting a three off the dribble or even in the post-up. Great, elite, fantastic, iconic guards who could do it all have superior footwork. Believe that.
Barnes plays four. He joins Sabonis at the five. Fox runs point with Herter by his side. And it's Davis in at the three. So that's the five in the game for Sacramento. All right, let's check in with Ali LaForce.
Thanks a lot, Brian. Well, the Kings made a big trade last season to acquire all-star Domantas Sabonis. It's clear they want a break from their lead long playoff drought, and they're hoping he can help them do it. He said, quote, "It's exciting. I want to be here. We're going to fight and get wins." Back to you.
Yeah, they're all in, Ali. Thank you. Now here's Herter. Fox, the pass to Barnes. No! They're unable to get the tying basket there. Outside Holiday. Puts it up from 12. Portis' shot is off.
That's a shot he'd like back. He's usually going to make those.
Something Bobby Portis has truly captured is the love of the fans, Clark.
Yeah, his energy and enthusiasm is palpable and contagious, but he also puts in the work, and fans recognize that hard work.
Here's Dragic. The Kings getting their last shot to go. Outside Holiday. 4-3. Offensive board. Portis gets the bucket.
Portis
has gotten his second bucket on the night.
Well, I love the way he goes after it there. I mean, and you've got to respect that. He's rewarded for his efforts of pursuing the ball.
The floater, and he's knocked off course by the D. So the foul is called, and he'll shoot free throws. We'll grab the shocker of the 2022 trade deadline. Domantas Sabonis going to the Kings.
Big time surprise. Tyrese Haliburton going the other way to Indy. Now, I like that deal for both sides. Sacramento adding an all-star big. The Kings needing some size. Sabonis adds that.
Free throw drops for Sabonis.
Well, I tell you, the Bucks are a big, tough, physical team, even in the backcourt. That's part of why they won the championship in 21 and are contenders going forward as long as they stay healthy.
Murray's checked in for the Kings. And Milwaukee also making a switch. Lopez has checked in. Both good from the line that time. You know, Clark, on top of that physicality, the Bucks have guys who can stretch the floor now.
Yeah, it's a nice combination, B.A. They can create space without having to play small ball. Not many teams can do that. Makes them one of the more unique squads in the league.
And the Bucks making a change here. Matthews checked in. Fox with the ball. He had an 18-point outing in their last game against the Suns in Phoenix. Over Dragic. And it's Fox missing. The Bucks have gotten just 2 of 6 field goals to go in the second. Middleton outside. Pass to Dragic. Now Holiday. Just 5 on the clock. Lopez, the screen on Murray. And it's Lopez. That time on the assist by Middleton. Lopez has gotten his first points in this one.
And they keep on figuring out ways to force the rock inside and convert. Pretty clear. It's smash mouth basketball. Pound that thing inside.
Now here's Murray. Looking at his production. Close to 12 points a game. Lopez against Sabonis. Herder. Oh, can't tie it up as that one misses. Dragic against Fox. And here's Dragic. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Middleton, no good. Barnes passes to Herder. Middleton against Murray. Back to Fox. Murray, no good.
Looking for the spectacular and coming up empty.
And you know, guys, always a tough catch on the lob. Placement and timing have to be close to perfect.
Milwaukee has gone 0 for 2 from outside in the second quarter.
2 minutes remaining in the first half. 2 minutes.
Now Holiday. He had an 18-point outing in their last game against Golden State. And that one's good. Middleton.
Boy, that is a real weapon in Middleton's arsenal. I mean, you hit a 3 on him, he wants that sweet revenge, and he's coming back at you.
Timeout called. Sacramento.
We are going out right now! Let's go, everybody! Time to make some noise! We are Sacramento Kings Breakers!
New group getting ready for the Kings. Lenz checked in for Domantas Sabonis. Rashawn Holmes comes in for Barnes. Monk, he's checked in for Herder. And Mitchell subbed in for De'Aaron Fox. A 1:50 left in the first half of this game. Pass to Lynn. They kick it out to Murray. Again, the miss by the Kings.
And I'm surprised that didn't go down. I mean, I'm sure he is too.
Lopez with it. Let's go with a 3. The rebound by Murray. Now Monk. Outside Mitchell. Clock at 6. From the arc. The rebound by Matthews. For Milwaukee, they've gone 4 of 10 from the field in the second. Pass to Carter. Fires for 3. The rebound by Murray. Murray's got his 4th rebound in this one. Here's Mitchell. He's coming off a 13-point game against the Suns in Phoenix. To the middle. Here's Holmes. Oh, it's Holmes with the big jam.
And this guy, to me, embodies determination. Small in his position, but he still gets up and keeps plays alive. That's mind over matter for sure.
Now here's Carter. He's coming off a 13-point game against Golden State. Pass to Matthews. And the foul on Brook Lopez. That's his first foul of the game.
First personal foul. First team foul. Substituting on the court.
Sacramento has gone just 1 of 5 so far this quarter from three. Carter against Mitchell. Good on the leaner. Mitchell's got 5 points.
Gotta fight harder to get over those screens.
Well, I'm gonna credit the screen. I mean, that's a good, strong pick he lays there.
The Bucks, 25.
Thanks. I'm here with head coach Mike Budenholzer. Coach, how would you characterize the intensity level in that first half?
Yeah, no, it's pretty intense. You know, both teams are getting after it defensively. Nothing's going to be easy, so it's the way it's supposed to be.
Hopefully it continues in the second half. Thanks.
All right, good stuff, Allie. And we'll get back to the action at the start of the third quarter.
Hey, everybody. I got a secret. We're approaching the playoffs, and we are starting the show with a breakdown of the Western Conference standings.
And taking a look at the Kings, they're right where they want to be, and they're right where they should be. Now it's a matter of getting everything in place for the title run. These guys will be tough to beat in a 7-game series.
Let's switch back to the Sacramento Kings, dealing with a thin margin at the half.
You could tell they love playing in front of this crowd. The energy helps fuel this team right now. The sixth man is doing their job, Shaq.
Yeah, there's no let up in these fans, loyal and loud.
That does it for halftime. Let's get back to game action. Here's Brian Anderson with the start of the third quarter.
Second half action for you. Thus far, a pretty evenly contested game. Domantas Sabonis with a strong contribution so far in this one.
Through the first two quarters, he's been on fire. Explosive offensive performance.
And you know what? I'll be interested to see just how much he's got left in the tank. That first half had to take a lot out of him.
Second half of basketball is upon us, and we may be in for an exciting finish based on how close of a game we've seen so far. Taking a look at the Bucks. Middleton is the three, with Giannis playing the power forward. Holiday and Allen are at guard form, and it's Lopez in at the five, roaming the paint. Antetokounmpo, bam!
Really confident from the interior. Because of his length and strength, Giannis feels like he can score from anywhere, anytime.
And from the sideline, let's catch up with Allie.
Thanks, Brian. Well, De'Aaron Fox is a competitor. He said, "I want to win. I know there's more than I can do. Just trying to create a spark, some type of energy. You can talk about what you did in high school and college, but you have to take it to a totally different level if you want to be one of those guys in the league." Brian?
Allie, thank you. Pass to Allen. Right wing. Antetokounmpo against Murray. And count it. Now 5 for 7.
Boy, he's just zoned in. I mean, in most cases, taking quality shots very much within the flow of the offense.
Perhaps the best trait of Giannis is loyalty, Clark.
Love that about him, B.A. We've seen others test those free agent waters. No begrudgment there, but not Giannis. Staying in Milwaukee, a small market team, signing an extension in 2020, and then led the Bucks to that 2021 title. The Greek Freak didn't need to get to a super team to get a ring. He burst and led a super team right where he was.
Two shots.
First free throw is good. Both free throws good from Allen. 90 seconds into the second half now. Holiday against Fox. Right side Herter, six to shoot. Off target with the three.
You know, scoring efficiency has been low and it's not helping them on the scoreboard.
Kicks it out to Antetokounmpo. Jam.
How about the flash by Antetokounmpo? I mean, just an insanely talented athlete who loves to punish that rim.
And that replay courtesy of the AT&T 5G Slam King. Sabonis outside. Back to Herter. The shot is good on the assist by Sabonis. Herter's gotten his third basket of the night.
The defense couldn't collapse quickly enough.
A little under 2.5 minutes gone by in the third quarter. Pass to Lopez. Jacks up a three. The rebound by Murray. Murray's got 5 rebounds tonight.
Only their first miss in 4 attempts. It's been a great start to the half.
Sabonis in the post, working on Lopez. Offensive rebound, and Sabonis slams it in.
Well, one of the things that stands out with Domantas Sabonis, this guy is high energy all the time. He's a relentless glass eater.
To the paint. Here's Allen. Kept alive, and another shot. And it's finished off by Antetokounmpo as he lays it in. Antetokounmpo has got 8 here in this quarter. Fox, the pass to Sabonis. Outside Herter. This for the tie! He can't get it to go. Milwaukee goes the other way with it.
He's looking pretty unsettled at the moment. Doesn't seem like he has a great feel for his shot.
Antetokounmpo, the pass to Lopez. The shot, no good. Nice D from Sabonis.
One reason this game is so tight is because both teams are hitting the boards with reckless abandon.
The battle to a standstill on the boards has really been something to watch. The game's not over yet. We'll see if one of these teams maintains more energy than the other going down the stretch.
Timeout called. Milwaukee.
Please welcome to the floor your 916 crew.
So both teams changing it up here. And how about we check the numbers for Joe Ingles?
And over the last 5 games, his field goal percentage has increased. And you can make a case his confidence as well because of this.
.156 left in the third quarter. And he's going to the line for 2. The official saw contact while he was going up.
Defense has Giannis well covered, but he gets physical right back and draws the foul in the act of shooting.
And a chance for a moment to check out the scoring breakdown for the Bucks.
Well, they've had no problem getting into the heart of this defense with dribbles, and they've made the most of their chances there as well.
You know, another thing that stands out to me is their passing in this game. I mean, they've done a tremendous job sharing the ball and setting each other up for success.
First free throw is good.
He's a nightly triple-double threat, and I think Giannis is the most unguardable player in the game.
Thank you. And so Antetokounmpo nails both of them. And so here's Sacramento. It's a three-point game. Outside Mitchell.
This for the tie!
Antetokounmpo grabs the board. Antetokounmpo's got four rebounds in the game.
The first thing I think of when watching Davion Mitchell is defense. Mitchell entered the league as one of the best on-the-ball defenders out there. And I just love how he's making the effort plays that everyone around him appreciates.
It is certainly making an impact tonight.
Well, you know, if you're not going to take care of the defensive glass, it's going to be hard to come away with the win.
Down low. Here's Holmes. That one falls. Nice setup by Mitchell. No doubt, Davion Mitchell is an elite defensive guard. Why is that, Grant?
Well, B.A., despite standing 6 feet, he's got a 6'5 wingspan. Mitchell is really strong and quick. But the biggest thing, Davion never takes a possession off.
And the Bucks with the possession here. After the Kings picked up a basket a moment ago. Count that one.
There are nights that Antetokounmpo can reach a level few have in NBA history. The MVP feeling it tonight.
Here's Lyles. Now quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game.
Javon Carter, first personal foul. First team foul. At the line for your Kings, Davion Mitchell. Two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. Both free throws good for Mitchell. The Bucks have gotten 6 of 10 shots to fall in this third quarter. We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and game clock. Here's Antetokounmpo. That one falls. Now 10 for 12 with that make.
Perfect dime drop that time. Nice execution of the bounce pass.
Now here's Mitchell. He has 7.
The floor general taking things into his own hands.
Just the aggression they're looking for, man.
And it just forces the defense to pay more attention to him, guys, which we know can open up things for others.
Giannis Antetokounmpo has been on display for the Milwaukee Bucks. Oh, what a quarter. He was absolutely on fire offensively. We're coming right back. Don't go anywhere. And it's time now to bring you our State Farm assist to the game.
Yeah, just shredding the defense with that feed. Zero chance to stop that.
Yeah, that's just a brilliant read of the defense. I mean, it was also excellent anticipation of the movement of his teammates before the pass. Just great harmony on all sides.
And with three quarters behind us, we'll start the fourth in what is still anybody's ballgame. Domantas Sabonis out there with Alex Lynn. Then there's De'Aaron Fox. Then there's Davis. And it's Monk in at the two. That's the five out there for the Kings. And it's Fox missing. Milwaukee in the lead. Allen finds Holiday. And he's going for the oop here. And Antetokounmpo with the stuff.
And Antetokounmpo is so long. I mean, he stretches forever, covers a ton of ground.
Here's Sabonis, rebounded by the Bucks. Antetokounmpo's got 6 rebounds here tonight. And the jam by Antetokounmpo.
Giannis powering his way on the jam there. Well done.
Fox against Holiday. Fox, the pass to Sabonis. That one goes. Count it.
And his fantastic performance from the last game has carried over to tonight.
And you know, that's how it goes with him and me. His hot streaks, guys, don't last minutes. They last days.
Pass to Antetokounmpo. Allen on the wing. Fires the three. They get it back. Portis. And then Portis with the dunk.
That'll drive your coach crazy. Failing to box out. Ugh.
Those are free points you're giving away. You gotta work harder on the glass.
Outside Davis. Here's Lynn. Now here's Sabonis. Defended by Portis. The rebound by Allen. Antetokounmpo outside. Moving along. 2 minutes gone in the fourth.
Everything right except the finish. Have to keep focused all the way through the play.
Antetokounmpo against Fox. Here's Lynn. Yes! And a nice assist from Fox. Fox has got his sixth assist of the night. The Bucks have gone 3 of 5 since this fourth quarter started. Antetokounmpo outside. Banks in the layup. Antetokounmpo has got 30.
Throughout the second half, they've achieved excellent efficiency on the offensive end.
Yeah, they're in a nice zone right now, and that basket looks, you know, it can handle two balls at once. It looks like now it could probably, for them, handle 3 or 4 balls at once as well as they're shooting.
Shots good by Sabonis.
Really sweet passing from Fox. He's a reliable floor general and has great vision on the court.
Ingles, a screen on Fox. Here's Holiday, and there's a whistle. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
Heady play to stop that easy layup right there. I mean, make him earn it at the line.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, free throws are always better than a layup, so I'd agree with you there.
At the line for two.
Good from Holiday.
You know, in the case of Jrue Holiday, having two brothers in the league, I think probably is added motivation for him to excel.
And some changes here for the Kings. Murray's checked in for Lynn. Barnes comes in for Davis. And Herter's subbed in for Monk. Lopez, he's checked in for the Bucks. Chris Middleton comes in for Ingles. Holiday hits them both.
Yeah, they've really made a concerted effort to get to the line here in the second half.
That's exactly how you do it. Defender pressing up on you, you press right back.
Pass to Barnes. Takes the three. Yes! And a nice assist from Fox. Fox has got assist number 8 now on the night. The Bucks have gotten 4 shots out of 6 attempts to drop so far in the fourth. And here's Lopez from the arc. Milwaukee, no good that time either.
Hey, you know, I like the competitive spirit. When you look at it, I think he rushed that three a little bit because he was trying to get back at his opponent.
Milwaukee has gone 0-for-2 from outside here in the fourth quarter. Holiday against Barnes. Pass to Antetokounmpo. For three, Allen. Hauled in by the Kings. Sabonis has got 6 rebounds in the game. Herter with it. And here's Sabonis. He's covered by Holiday. Shots good by Sabonis. And now just a 2-point Bucks lead.
Pivotal bucket from Sabonis there. This guy just continues to rise to the challenge.
Antetokounmpo inside. Defended by Murray. Antetokounmpo. That's good.
Well, I tell you, the future of the Greek Freak is extremely bright. I mean, he really has shown the ability to deliver in important spots of game.
Fox, the pass to Sabonis. The rebound by the Bucks. 1:19 left in the game. Antetokounmpo outside. Inside. Here's Lopez. Antetokounmpo gets the assist. Now it's a 6-point Milwaukee lead.
It all comes down to this possession. They must get points.
It really does come down to this. I mean, come up empty and it's over.
Sabonis with a screen on Holiday. Here's Fox. That one doesn't drop. Milwaukee goes the other way with it. Antetokounmpo with it. He's picked up by Barnes. And so they foul intentionally.
Personal foul. Second team foul.
Holiday doubled up. Lopez passes to Middleton. And here is Antetokounmpo. Three-pointer. Holiday drops in the three. And the Bucks lead by nine.
Stepping up and nailing an important shot to put this away.
And, you know, this run shows what kind of attitude this team has. I mean, the win is there. Go get it.
Fox, the pass to Herter. Can they get it? Rebound by Middleton. Here's Milwaukee. They lead by the biggest margin of the game at nine. Holiday with the ball. And so it's Milwaukee with the W. They have to feel good about this performance. It's one they can be proud of.
Very true. I mean, when you're out on the road, the wins can feel a little sweeter. This one has to feel extra special.
Well, now we have some time to check in with Allie LaForce. Allie.
Giannis, you said these games start to matter more as you come down the stretch. Can you tell me more about that?
Just coming out here, try to play good basketball, try to play together, and try to get better. You know, we just try to get in that playoff shape and just get better.
Championship always on your mind. Thanks, Giannis.
Allie, thank you as always. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Grant Hill, Allie LaForce, and Clark Kellogg, this is Brian Anderson thanking you all for tuning in tonight as New Balance presents our player of the game, Giannis Antetokounmpo.